Well, it still gives you goosebumps.
Yeah. The hills are alive with the sound of music, with songs they have sung.
5 Academy Awards, including Best Picture, and if it didn't win, I would never go on to another movie. This year, The Sound of Music is 40 years old. It stars, well, they all stayed the same age. The 40th anniversary DVD is hitting stores next Tuesday, and it has all kinds of extras. The cast, they've gotten together again for the first time in 20 years to celebrate with new bells and whistles on this DVD. And joining us, Julie Andrews. Julie Andrews, there she is. Who, as Maria von Trapp, brought light and music into the lives of the 7 von Trapp children who are all here. Liesl, played by Charmian Carr.
Come on,
Brigitta, Angela Cartwright. The eldest son, Friedrich, played by Nicholas Hammond. The baby of the family, Gretel, that's Kim Carath. Marta, who was played by Debbie Turner. Kurt, who was played by Dwayne Chase. And Louisa, played by Heather Menzies-Urich. So this is really great to see everybody all grown up. Because we watch you on videotape and you're all still that high.
Didn't they all do well?
They did.
That's great.
Now, every time, Julie, I watch the movie, I see the opening scene. You're on the hills, you're singing.
Yeah.
And then there's that incredible shot, and I'm thinking, why don't I hear the helicopter?
You didn't. I saw it, believe me, and I felt it. Every time the helicopter went around to do one more shot, the downdraft from the jets just leveled me into the ground. It did.
And didn't the helicopter pilot know what he was doing to you?
Not really, because I kept asking him to go wider and wider, and I just got a thumbs up, you know, good shot.
You look terrific there, lying on the ground.
Yeah. I wish there were some outtakes of that. There must be somewhere.
They do indeed show you on the EPK with the helicopter going around.
Do they?
On the extras on the DVD. Now, this was 1965.
Yes, I think if memory serves, it was.
In 1962, you did that famous Carnegie Hall concert with Mary Martin.
With Carol Burnett.
Mary Martin. Mary Martin was in the...
Well, she was in the original production.
Yes, I'm thinking of the original production of Broadway. But you did it with Carol Burnett, and you spoofed. You spoofed Sound of Music.
Yeah, but who knew then?
I want to play a little clip of that great concert with you and Carol.
We are the Happy Swiss Family Press. We bring you a happy song that I used to sing when I was a happy nun back home in Switzerland.
Who knew? Who knew?
Now, we want to hear from each of you and the range of professions, from floral design to production companies to computer engineering, is amazing. Yeah. But someone is not here. And that's Christopher Plummer.
Yes, he's making a movie in Los Angeles.
He's making a movie, but he's here in spirit. Now, is this true?
I really think he is. I'm serious. Diane, I wanted to say, do you know who helped write that spoof?
No.
Mike.
My husband?
Oh,
yes.
Really?
I should have known. Yes. I'm sure of it. There's nothing sacred that he doesn't have made fun of once or twice in his life, that's for sure. But we're going to hear from him in a minute. But first, we were all, I think, going on 16, going on 17 is probably...
You sang, Charmian, you sang 16, going on 17, because it wouldn't have sounded right if you'd actually sung what was true, was I am 21, going on 22.
Yes. It wouldn't have rhymed.
But that's what you were at the time.
Yes.
You all had to play different ages?
Well, not the rest.
No, I was 5.
You really were?
I really was 5.
Really were 5.
Yes, much to everybody's chagrin, because I couldn't work as long of hours.
But I was going to ask you, Charmian, because is it true that Christopher Plummer didn't like working with kids very much and called it The Sound of Mucus?
Oh, yes, it's true.
I saw it because he thought it was going to be so sweet and so saccharine, which, of course, it turned out not to be at all.
Yeah.
It turned out to be
mostly thanks to him, too.
Yes.
Really, if he hadn't added that
strengthened
those.
Nine months of shooting, and I understand you grew 6 inches in those 9 months?
I started out at 5'3" and ended up at 5'9". So poor Charmy and the others, because we had to stay in a line, and I started out, you know, with lifts in my shoes, and by the end, I was in no shoes, and she was standing on a box.
And if we really watch closely, can we see that?
Well, you can see the hair color changing a little bit.
And the lederhosen getting shorter.
Now, Heather, tell me, you and Kim should tell me about, and Kim, you'll have to talk into my microphone, about the water scene and the boat flipping over.
Oh, yes, that was lots of fun because she didn't know how to swim.
You didn't?
No,
and I did not know how to swim. And I'm still not very fond of the water after that experience, to tell you the truth.
And I had to carry her out of the water because she couldn't swim. And there she is.
And who had to fish you out?
My sister's ex-husband, actually.
No, actually me. What you don't know is that they said just before the take, the little one can't swim. Please fall to the front of the boat so that you can get to her quickly. And of course, I went right out the back instead.
So that's when my sister's ex-husband jumped in.
Well, again, I do want to play the tape of Chris Plummer because he wanted to be here so much and something he wanted to say to all you. Here it is.
Super.
Suddenly, the press started to kind of mysteriously crowd around the set all the time, and there was always someone showing up, some columnist, some showing up to do interviews, and I said to Julie, my God, what is all this? This sort of smells like this is maybe going to be a hit. And she said, well, maybe it is, and can you imagine, we both might be famous. And that was our sort of conversation. We were kidding around, you know, and of course it happened.
Boy, did it happen.
He said he wanted to send you love. Now, Julie, as I understand, when you all were this high, taught you to say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious backwards.
Yes. Docious-aliaexpialisticexfragilicalibrucus.
Yes!
Wait a minute. I want the microphone on you one more time.
Docious-aliaexpialisticexfragilicalibrucus.
You all did that.
She taught us when we were sitting
couldn't
on the
couldn't do it backwards.
You taught you one?
She taught us that when we were all sitting on the end of the bed before filming
things.
It was our very first thing we did together. It was the first time we were all on film together. It was that scene, and I think we were all a bit nervous, and she settled us down by teaching us songs from this film no one had heard of called Mary Poppins.
I mean, they were forgotten.
Well,
you also told us some wonderful jokes.
Yes, were they okay?
Funny. I mean, they were fine.
Oh, good.
Any of them repeatable on morning television?
Yeah. Well, maybe not all of them.
Jokes that she should have been telling a five-year-old?
I don't remember anyway.
Well, we should finish this. We should all sing.
We have to.
Yes. What would
should
you like
we
to do?
Really well, you should sing, John.
I'll join in, Bobby.
If you start us off, we want you to start us off, and then we'll all join in. Whatever you decide to do. Mom?
Which song would you like to do?
What will it be?
I guess my favorite. Let's do Edelweiss.
Okay. Oh, good. I was hoping you were going to say The Sound of Music, because I can't hit those notes.
All right. On the count of three.
It's good.
You lead.
Really?
Sure.
Yes. Oh, Charlie, I wish you'd lead us off into this.
Two, please.
Okay.
You lead us.
Edelweiss, Edelweiss.
Come on, Charlie.
Every morning you greet me.
That's it.
Small and white.
You're not even on the
and bright. You look happy to me.
Come on, you can't get out of it.
Blossom of snow, may you bloom and grow, bloom and grow forever.
There we are.
Edelweiss, Edelweiss, bless my homeland.